Hello, I'm Frank Sanders, Senior Technical Fellow at the Institute for Telecommunication Sciences, ITS, a laboratory in Boulder, Colorado. ITS is part of the National Telecommunications and Information Administration, NTIA, in the U.S. Department of Commerce. At ITS, we advance innovation, inform policy, and investigate telecom problems for the benefit of our nation. We are working now with the Joint Interagency 5G Radar Altimeter Interference, that's JFRI, group to protect critical radar altimeter readouts and supporting safe aircraft landings. In 2021, the Federal Communication Commission, FCC, auctioned licenses for new 5G wireless carrier services to operate in a radio frequency, RF, range, just below the safety of life aircraft radio altimeter RF range. Radar altimeters operate in the band to measure the distance between an aircraft and the ground. They are crucial to aircraft landings in low visibility conditions like heavy fog, snow, and rain. They are also used to prevent what's called controlled flight into terrain, CFIT. The frequency ranges used by aircraft and wireless carriers are different. Aircraft altimeters use the 4.2 to 4.4 gigahertz frequency range. The spectrum auctioned to 5G wireless carriers ranges from 3.7 to 3.98 gigahertz. ITS field strength measurements will help to determine if the 220 MHz spectrum separation between the two frequency ranges for 5G and the radar altimeters is enough to avoid interference to radar altimeter receivers from 5G transmitted signals. ITS performs over-the-air radio frequency testing at our Table Mountain Advanced Communication Test Site as part of our end-to-end comprehensive approach to spectrum sharing research. We're assessing 5G field strength in space around 5G transmitter base stations and 5G phones on the ground. For this effort, we're using mobile truck transmitters known as cell-on-light truck or CoLTs. The intent is to understand field strength as a function of where you are in space, up in the sky where airplanes fly, around these base station antennas. For these measurements, we hired a piloted Robinson R-44 Raven helicopter. An ITS engineer on board operated an ITS compact 5G field strength measurement system with two calibrated cavity-backed spiral measurement antennas mounted on the bottom and the end of a pole that protruded from the side of the helicopter. The ITS measurement system includes a controller to switch between the system's two cavity-backed antennas. The antenna at the end of the pole is used when flying around or past the CoLT laterally, while the antenna facing downward on the bottom side of the pole is used when we're flying directly above the CoLT. That way we're able to measure the field strength in three dimensions no matter where our helicopter is relative to the base station transmit antenna. During flights, ITS also provided ground-based 5G signal monitoring to verify CoLT transmit power is proper and steady, that transmit channels are properly locked on the selected channels, that the modulation is correct, and that the bandwidth is correct and steady, and that the CoLT antenna beams themselves are correctly positioned. ITS gathered measurements for all five planned helicopter flight patterns over the course of an afternoon. The goal for these flight patterns was threefold. First, to learn how to configure the CoLT for subsequent comprehensive flight testing at other locations. Second, to measure the emission spectra of the 5G base station CoLT transmitter operating at its full power to determine if there are any unintentional spectrum emissions in the radar altimeter band, and if such emissions were seen, how strong they are. And third, to measure the radiation pattern from the CoLT in space in three dimensions where airplanes fly as the helicopter flies around, past, and over the CoLT's transmitter antenna. This effort included no simulations. We used a real 5G base station, talking to 10 real 5G phones with real traffic running. With the base station and phones exchanging communication in a steady state test mode, we measured the actual 5G power in space, in the sky, where airplanes fly. It's important to note that 5G base stations normally tilt their beams somewhat downward below their local horizons to transmit to phones, not up into the sky where airplanes are at. In these graphs are examples of some of the data we took in the sky. They show how much power is radiated unintentionally around 5G base station antennas. This power is an inevitable result of the physics of how antennas work. With our sophisticated data analysis tool set, we can also play back data captures to watch them change in time and space. This animation is from a set of earlier in-the-air dry run measurements that we did, flying around two mobile trailer-mounted cells-on-wheels, cows, 5G base stations at Table Mountain. Here, one of the cows is pink, the other is blue, and a bright green asterisk denotes the helicopters traveling around the cows. This is the actual pattern the helicopter flew as recorded by onboard GPS receivers. The pattern displays heat map coloring, where yellow indicates higher or stronger in-air measured power, and burgundy indicates lower, weaker in-the-air measured power. The bottom of the animation plots the helicopter's elevation as it's traveling in time. Stay tuned for our data analysis from these in-air measurements. This work is just one way that ITS is informing spectrum and communication policy for the benefit of all stakeholders. We investigate our nation's most pressing telecommunication challenges through research that our employees are proud to deliver.